Left channel?
Beep.
Right channel? Beep, beep.
Concert and saw some guy named Yo Mama.
That's Yo-Yo Ma.
Oh, that name's so much better.
So, what's for lunch today, Spam Head?
His name is Sam.
Shut up, Four Eyes. So, what's for dessert?
Give it back.
Give it back what?
Give it back, please?
Give it back, please, what?
Give it back, please.
Okay? Okay. Oh, look. That's the way the cookie crumbles.
What are you doing, Corey?
Woman, get out of my face.
I'm tired of you picking on Sam.
Lisa. And what are you gonna do about it?
Knock you into next week.
Lisa.
And when Principal Gilroy asks who started this fight, just remember, one of us has straight A's and one of us doesn't.
Waited for you, Spam Head.
Next time you get in trouble, call me.
Hey, Sam. Were you gonna eat that chocolate chip?
Everything but lick it.
I'm serious, Darryl. This place has got to be sparkling.
Honey, it's just my mother. What is that supposed to mean?
I'm sorry, sweetheart. Your mom's wonderful. She's sweet, caring, and devoted. And why does she drive me crazy?
My mother adores you. She only says the nicest things about you.
Well, it's not what she says so much as how she says it.
Well, how does she say it?
Well, it's more why she says it.
Well, why did she say it?
Well, you know, come to think of it, it is what she says.
Was there a specific moment when you turned weird, or was it a gradual thing?
I can't explain it. I'll tell you what. The next time your mother says something annoying, I'll, signal you.
How?
I don't know. I'll say something like, Darryl, want some coffee?
Ooh, cold.
Shouldn't that cab be here by now?
Oh, they're not taking a cab. Anthony showed Mom the wisdom in renting him a car for the weekend.
Oh, that sounds expensive.
Well, Anthony wouldn't mind that.
Oh, baby.
It's just that Mom is just used to giving and giving to her kids, and Anthony's used to taking.
I left extra towels in the bathroom for your mother. When does her broom get in?
Daddy, are we going to have to hear this all weekend?
No, I'll be in hiding. Call me when she's in the shower so I can flush.
I can't believe you're still angry with my mom after all this time.
That woman threw wedding cake at me.
Yeah, after you made that toast. Here's to my lovely daughter and what's his name?
I just had a little too much champagne. It was a joke. Sort of. She just pulled up. She'd better hurry inside before somebody drops a house on her.
Don't you even think about opening up that door.
Okay? Let the games begin.
Darryl!
Mom.
Oh,
My big boy, Virginia.
Benny. So, what took you guys so long?
Anthony wanted to show the car rental off to a few of his friends.
I look good in a Thunderbird. Couldn't you just drop Mom off first?
Oh, I didn't mind. Ooh, my baby.
No pinching, you promise.
Would anyone care for something to drink?
No, I don't want to be any trouble. Just some hot tea.
Oh, there's no trouble. I'll make a fresh pot.
Oh, you wonderful girl. But just a cup will do.
Cream and sugar?
A little sugar and some half and half.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't have any half and half.
Really?
I could mix together some cream and milk.
Oh, no, no, no. It doesn't taste quite right. You know, they know how to blend it properly at the factory. I'll just skip the tea. Oh, but no reflection on you.
Darryl, want some coffee?
No. So, Mom, how do you like living in Baton Rouge?
Oh, I love it. It's nice to be home again. Except I miss my baby and my big boy.
Betty, would you care to freshen up?
Oh, how thoughtful of you. Yes, I would. Thank you. Oh, there is soap in the bathroom.
Darryl, are you sure you don't want some coffee?
Oh, yeah, Mom, there's plenty of soap. I'm booking. The store closes in half an hour.
What store?
Nuvo Uno Electronics. I want to check out the new Tino Flex video cameras, the ultimate machine for the aspiring filmmaker.
I thought you already bought that camera.
Oh, he was saving up, but he blew the bucks on a big date. Several big dates.
I'm researching an alternative source of funding.
I'm not loaning you any more money.
Oh.
Mom, Anthony's got to go.
Oh, well, thanks for the lift. Do you need anything? Do you need some gas?
It is a big tank, and we did use some of the gas on the way over here.
Here's $20. You fill it up.
Thanks.
Darryl, I'd offer you $20, but I know you turn it down.
That's right.
I would.
Later.
Oh, take care, my baby.
Have a seat, Betty. Relax.
Mom, you look great. Baton Rouge must really agree with you.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart.
Darryl, have some coffee. Have a lot of coffee.
And that is how I know that she will live on in my memory. Thank you.
Very good, Tricia. Does anyone else have a special poem they'd like to share with the class? Donald, I'm surprised. I didn't know you were a poetry man.
Hey, I'm a well-rounded guy.
You can say that again.
Well, the floor is all yours. Let's hear what you've got.
Beans, beans, the musical fruit.
Donald.
What?
That's not what I had in mind.
But it rhymes, so it's a poem. And it's based on real life.
Hey, Sam, want to play some video games this afternoon? I guess that means no. What's with Sam?
Maybe he was embarrassed yesterday.
By what?
By letting a girl fight his battles.
I can't believe anyone still thinks about that stupid male-female stuff. Haven't we as a society come farther than that?
Nah.
In the hallway, desmudging the mirror.
Oh, and it took me hours to get those fingerprints just right.
Dinner smells wonderful. And hors d'oeuvres. How do you find time for all this cooking and going to doctor school, too? You must have had a heavy caseload this week.
She'll be gone in 2 days.
Gone in 2 days, gone in 2 days.
So, Mom, what do you have planned for tomorrow?
Well, Anthony is taking me to this nice little restaurant for lunch.
Can he afford that?
Well, he's taking me in the sense of driving me.
In the car that you rented for him?
Yeah. Something wrong with that?
Mom, you got to stop indulging Anthony. You're not a rich woman.
Oh, honey, Anthony needs help. And, oh, what can I do? I can't say no.
Saying no is exactly the kind of help he needs. Now, he needs to stand on his own 2 feet, and you need to let go.
Oh, honey, he's just a kid. He'll grow up. It just takes a little time. Ooh, Got some dirt on your cheek.
Mom, 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 Mom. I stopped lending Anthony money every time he asked for it, and eventually he went out and got himself a job. Then another and another, but you get my point.
Honey, if I can't give to my children, who can I give to?
Well, how about spending on yourself? When was the last time you went out and bought yourself something totally frivolous?
Last month, I bought a toaster.
What's frivolous about a toaster?
It was a four slicer.
Four slicer.
Oh, Darryl, I just can't say no to my children.
Well, will you please try? Now, this is the best thing for Anthony, and he knows it, too.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna go wash up for dinner.
Is there something I can help you do, Virginia?
Oh, would you like to set the table?
Oh, I'd love to. Virginia. Darryl. Betty. Anthony. Who's the fifth plate for?
Oh, my father.
Him?
You're not still angry at my father.
I'm not angry at him. He's angry at me.
Well, it's been 3 years since,
the incident.
Yes. And I think you two should try to get along.
Whatever you say.
Gone in 2 days. Gone in 2 days.
Well, don't keep me in suspense. How is it?
Mom, you've outdone yourself. This banana pudding is great.
It's delicious.
It's fantastic.
It's edible.
Would you like some wedding cake?
Daddy's such a kidder. Quit kidding, Daddy. Darryl, why don't you make a toast? The five of us are hardly ever together.
Oh, that's a great idea, honey.
Well, I'll just be going back upstairs. Time for Betty bye. Betty, bye.
Wait. Daddy, wait. Not until the toast is over.
I'd like to propose
wait,
a toast.
Wait, 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 wait. This is an important family moment, and I'd like to capture it on video.
Oh, later, Anthony. There's plenty of time for that.
Mom, you turning down family pictures?
Oh, Anthony, you got the new camera.
Yeah, isn't it a beaut, top of the line, and fully loaded? This baby does everything except tuck you in.
Oh, no. Where did you get the money? You didn't sell a rental car.
I thought we were gonna toast.
Chill out, D. It was a gift. Mom bought it for me.
Didn't we just have a conversation about this?
Oh, son, why ruin such a lovely evening? We're all having a wonderful time.
I can't believe you.
So I bought him a little camera.
Honey, would you like some coffee? Would you like to have a big pot of coffee?
You people need to decaffeinate.
What's the big deal, Dee? It was a gift. I, for one, can accept a gift graciously.
Damn it, Anthony, why don't you grow up and show some responsibility?
Wait a second.
Oh, you don't mean that, Darryl.
Yes, I do. You're not going to be around forever.
Oh, is that the toast?
Anthony needs to grow up and stand on his own 2 feet.
Oh, I'm standing, Darryl. I'm standing and I'm walking. I'll be right back.
Oh, Mom. Anthony,
no, don't. No, leave. No, 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 Jenny. Darryl's just jealous. I don't have to take that, Darryl.
Anthony!
Oh, Darryl!
Virginia!
To family.
Darryl, are you coming to bed?
Good night. Oh.
Would you like to talk about what happened tonight, or do you want to just sulk?
I'm not sulking, I'm brooding.
I hate it when you're like this.
You should, I'm mad. I'm mad at my mother because she doesn't have a clue as to what's good for Anthony. Anthony just sponges off Mom, and I'm mad at your father because... Well, I don't need a reason. And I'm mad at you.
Me? What did I do?
You bought the most uncomfortable fold-out bed in the history of the world.
Welcome to the floor.
You know, Anthony's calling me jealous. I'm not jealous. I'm angry.
You're just mad because Anthony's approach to life is different than yours.
Oh, yeah, right. Anthony's approach to life is, hello, life. Let's partay. Anthony just breezes through life and he gets away with it.
That's right. He's not responsible like you. He's not dependable like you. He is not like you.
Well, he should be like me.
No, he shouldn't. He should be like Anthony. You've got to let your brother grow up in his own way. You've got to let go.
Sounds like what I said to Mom.
Oh, it's still good advice.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Guess you're right. You know, you're pretty smart. And pretty sweet. Pretty, pretty.
Sorry if I'm disturbing you. But I'm having trouble sleeping. Oh, I hope it's not something I ate for dinner. Anyway, we certainly know it wasn't the banana pudding.
Gone in 2 days. Gone in 2 days.
Man, I saw what happened in the cafeteria yesterday. The whole school's laughing at you.
Yeah.
All I know is, if I were you, I wouldn't let that happen again.
Trust me, I won't. Trust me, it's a really simple plan.
Shh.
I still don't get it. Trisha, do I have to spell it out for you?
Yes.
Give me strength. Look, if this works, then Sam will think we're even, and then we can be friends again.
I don't know, Lisa.
Watch and learn. I think I'll save my apple for later. I just love apples. I said I just love apples.
Hey, that's my apple.
You mean it was your apple? It's my apple now. I saw this once on People's Court. Judge Wapner decided the only fair thing to do was to make applesauce.
How would you like to be applesauce?
Oh, right. Sorry.
You can't take my apple. Give it back.
Make me.
Please give me back my apple.
I said make me.
Oh, no. What am I gonna do? I need someone to help me.
How about Sam?
That's a great idea.
Sam, you're my friend. What do you say?
Go for it, Silvio.
Sam, I need your help just like you needed mine.
Smooth move, Lisa.
I still don't get it. Did her plan work or not?
I don't understand. This worked on Punky Brewster.
You saw this on Punky Brewster?
There's your problem.
Sam, you've got to talk to me.
Says who?
Says me. I don't know why you're so upset. Everyone thinks it's because you let a girl defend you, but I know that's not true.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is!
Whoa, chill out. I defended you because you're my friend. The fact that I'm a girl isn't important.
It sure is. Do you know how many guys will call me names?
Names can't hurt you.
Do you know how many guys have to beat me up?
That can hurt you.
All because of you.
I didn't think about that. I guess I'll just have to be more patient with society.
Yeah, I guess you do.
Okay, I promise. Next time I see someone trying to beat you up, I'll let them.
Thanks. You're a real friend.
Darryl?
Mom, how'd you sneak past the security guard?
You mean that nice Mr. Keck? He just loved my banana pudding.
So you fed your way in.
I love your classroom.
Yeah, I'm proud of it.
It's adorable. You're adorable. So this is where my big boy works.
That's right. This is where your big boy works.
You know, I was thinking about our conversation, and I feel badly about giving Anthony that camera.
Mom, listen, I may have been a little bit out of line. Whatever you and Anthony want to do is your business.
No, you're absolutely right, and I shouldn't let my selfish needs stand in the way of that.
I wouldn't say you were selfish.
No, I have a problem. I can't say no to my kids. And that's my sin.
Mom.
No, if they take what I offer, it gives me joy. When they say no to me, I can live with it.
Well, you don't have to offer things. You can just offer your love.
Oh, Darryl, there's nothing in the world that I love more than you and Anthony. I feel so much better that we had this little talk. I also feel as though I know you and Anthony better.
So you understand why I was angry with you and Anthony?
Of course.
Good, that makes me feel much better.
That's why I got something for you, too.
What?
Well, Virginia loves to make coffee so much, so I got her coffee maker top of the line with all the bells and whistles.
Come on, you said
that. Makes cappuccino, espresso, has an automatic timer, and I think it has a radio.
Mom, why did you buy this?
Because it was wrong of me to give just Anthony an expensive gift.
That's right.
And without giving you something also.
Listen.
I don't play favorites.
Mom, I have to explain something. This is lovely. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Oh, now you and Anthony are even.
Well, not exactly. That camera costs a lot more than this coffee maker.
You're absolutely right. Here's the rest and a gift certificate.
They weigh a ton.
Oh, I think I pulled a shoulder muscle.
Now you have something to remember me by.
I never thought of you as a pain in the shoulder.
Can't you two just pretend to be friends?
Nope.
Whatever you say.
Daddy! Whew. You can have these back now.
Oh, Virginia, I've got something to show you.
Oh, what?
Well, you have such a nice closet. I thought I'd organize it for you, and I want to show you where I put everything.
Gone in 2 minutes, gone in 2 minutes.
Sorry, I'm late.
No problem. Just make sure she doesn't miss that plane.
Is she ready?
Yeah, she's in the bedroom talking to Jenny. She'll be out in a second.
Oh.
Anthony, there's something I want to tell you.
No, there's something I want to tell you.
You go first.
Last night, I was so angry when I left here that I had to dance it off. I dropped by this club, and for the first time, they didn't check my ID. I'm getting old. And I don't even have a bank account. You know, I gotta get my act together. You're right, D. Now, what was it you had to tell me?
I was gonna say I was wrong.
What?
Yeah, I was talking to Jenny last night, and I can't tell you how to run your life. I mean, you gotta work it out for yourself. I may not agree with it, but that's not your problem.
No kidding.
I mean it.
You know, next time Mom offers me some money, I'm not taking it. I swear.
Whatever you do is cool with me.
Look, I want to remember my baby and my big boy just like this.
Come on, Mom, you don't want to miss the plane.
No, you don't want to miss the plane.
I had a wonderful time. Oh, thanks, and I'm going to see you soon.
Great.
Virginia, I want you to have this. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Betty.
You know, that wasn't so bad. I mean, I had a chance to talk to Anthony, and we worked it all out. And what are you doing?
I'm watching them leave. She might change her mind.
Jenny.
Oh, okay. They're walking to the car. They're putting the luggage in the trunk. Betty's opening up her purse. She's offering Anthony money. Anthony's not taking it.
All right, Anthony.
Oh, wait. Now they're talking and... Now he's taking it.
I can't believe it.
What the hell?
Oh.